is enduring and patient and kind. It judges all things with the heart, not the mind. And love can transform the most commonplace into beauty and splendor and sweetness and grace. For love is unselfish, giving more than it takes. And no matter what happens, love never forsakes. It's faithful and trusting, and always believing, guileless, honest, never deceiving. Yes, love is beyond what man can define, for love is immortal, and God's gift is divine. And underneath this refuge are the everlasting arms. So right now, cast your burden on Him. Seek God's counsel when distressed, and go to Him for comfort when you're lonely and oppressed. For God is our encouragement in troubles and in trials, and in suffering and sorrow. He will turn our grief to smiles. Now listen to the most profound theological statement ever uttered.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to Him belong, they are weak, but He is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, my Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me.
This is Nightsounds, and I thought I'd bring you a love song to begin tonight. Fred Frank singing two of the most beautiful and meaningful love songs ever written. A moment ago, I mentioned that very familiar children's song, Jesus Loves Me. I believe it was Carl Barth who made this statement originally, that this phrase, Jesus Loves Me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so, is the most profound theological statement ever uttered. But it's in the package of simplicity. And there is power in simplicity. I'm Bill Pearce, and we come your way, night by night, with a message of love, this message, in different packages. Sort of approaching you from different areas of thinking and vantage points. And tonight I just thought, as I was contemplating a subject at hand, that we can never run out of the need for love. We're wired for it. We need it. The Bible says so much about it. The greatest of all loves is that somebody died for us, was willing to give his life for us. That's the ultimate in caring and love. And tonight I thought I'd strike on a couple of bits of verse and poetry. Here's an anonymous poem that was sent to us by a listener. Love lugs luggage. Stays up late on the phone, making endless arrangements. Smiles at strangers. And even makes friends out of grumpy taxi drivers. Love washes clothes in little hotel basins. Gives up the best mattress and walks hot streets, finding cool drinks for tired throats. Love that is love has muscles. They are grown doing love. Love washes blouses at midnight, leaves meals ready in the fridge with little notes and endless instructions, fastened on with sticky tape or magnets. Love picks you up at school as a surprise, when you could just as easily take the bus, just for a chance to see you smile. Love never counts the miles walked, so never notices the extra one. Love laughs and cries. Love lives and tries. Love persists, like a disciplined athlete determined to win the crown. For costly caring, love that is love has muscles. They are grown doing love. In thinking of an appropriate title for tonight's program, I decided on this one. Merely, Love Will. This is good to know, and many of us have learned it through experience. And if you haven't yet, I pray that you will know the power of love in your own life, of not only giving it, but receiving it, because love always will.
Somebody's drifted too far from the shore. The night has fallen, the searchlight's calling. Somebody's ship is caught out in the storm. The winds are shaken, the waves overtaken. If there's a way home, if there's one hope still, love will search the sea for those desperate hearts. Love will be the guide through the wind and dark. Love will light the way for a homeward star. There's one hope still, love will. Mm-hmm.
Patti White singing the song, Love Will. And love does. It has done. And will do. We continue with the sounds of love. I was reading a quote from Dr. Richard Seltzer's book. He's a medical doctor who has gone through many experiences where he has seen love in operation. One particularly notable moment, he said, quote, I stand by the bed where a young woman lies. Her face post-operative, her mouth twisted in palsy. A tiny twig of the facial nerve, the one to the muscles of her mouth, has been severed. She will be thus from now on. The surgeon had followed with religious fervor the curve of her flesh. I promise you that. Nevertheless, to remove the tumor in her cheek, I had to cut that little nerve. Her young husband is in the room. He stands on the opposite side of the bed, and together they seem to dwell in the evening lamplight, isolated from me. Private. Who are they? I ask myself. He and this wry mouth I have made, who gaze at and touch each other so generously, greedily. The young woman speaks. Will my mouth always be like this? She asks. Yes, I say, it will. It's because the nerve was cut. She nods and is silent. But the young man smiles. I like it, he says. I think it's kind of cute. All at once, I know who he is. I understand. And I lower my gaze. One is not so bold in an encounter with such love. Unmindful, he bends to kiss her crooked mouth. And I'm so close, I can see how he twists his own lips to accommodate to hers, to show her that their kiss still works. Heard the story behind that hymn that was just played, Oh Love That Will Not Let Me Go. It was inspired by a very sad incident that happened in the life of George Matheson, the writer of this song, many years ago in Scotland, when the girl to whom he was engaged to be married, suddenly recognized that George was going blind physically. And she did not want to be saddled with a blind man the rest of her life. She broke the engagement. And that's when he wrote the words, "Oh, love that will not let me go." We hear about the gift of love so frequently, about how God has loved us and loved us so much that he gave his only son. And greater love has no person than this, that person laid down his life. But also we must learn to receive love and then cycle it back. That's what this great hymn is saying. My Jesus, I love you. I know you're mine. For you, all the pleasures of sin I resign. My gracious Redeemer, my Savior art thou. If ever I loved thee, my Jesus, 'tis now. It's through this cycle of love that we come your way on the program Night Sounds. Night by night, I sit behind this microphone, not knowing who you are or where you are exactly. But through history, through experience, I know somebody's there. Ultimately, many of you will respond. Some won't. Some aren't able. Others don't care, one way or another. But it's to all of these moods and frames of minds and spiritual, emotional, physical conditions that Jesus came to earth to touch. The uncaring, the unlovely, the sensitive, the insensitive. And as we reach a cross-section audience through radio once again, I've asked that his presence be sensed and be the communication factor. I don't speak for myself necessarily on this program, but it's a corporate effort. Many people pray, many are concerned, so many love, and that love is sensed and cycled back to him and to you. I feel it, and I'm so grateful. We try to touch you with love through the program you're hearing, our treasury of recorded music and speech. Just a few moments ago, I talked with a woman from Kentucky who called in desperation. 5 children, an uncaring husband, stress. Just to talk with someone, to see if anybody was there who understood. We prayed together. She helped me, I helped her, the Lord helped us both, and that's what it's all about. Thank you for being a part of this beautiful love cycle. I'd be delighted to hear from you. In case you care to write, our mailing address is Nightsounds, Wheaton, Illinois, 60189. One way of loving has already been mentioned, prayer concern. Here's a bit of verse that someone sent me this week, taken from Matthew, the Gospel, chapter 21, verse 22. The writer says, "I voiced a prayer for you today, and I know that God must have heard because I sensed the answer in my heart, though he spoke not a word. I prayed not for a lot of wealth, but just for what you need to live a life of usefulness without a thought of greed. I prayed not that your name be known throughout the country wide, but rather that in Jesus' name, therein lies all your pride. I prayed not for a life of ease, without a trace of dross, but rather for the grace to bear the burden of your cross. I prayed that you might ever use your talents for mankind, that others, seeing how you live, might peace with Jesus find. I prayed that you might lend a hand to those who need your aid, those who are lame or deaf or blind, to those of life afraid. I pray that you may ever dare to stand up for the right, to be a martyr for his cause, to do right in his sight. But most of all, I prayed to him that you might know above he has a home waiting for you, and that you might know his love. And again, the key verse from Matthew 21, all things whatsoever you shall ask in prayer, believing, you shall receive. That your heart might overflow, that you might live in peace and love, reaching out to others with that beautiful force in Jesus' name.
They lay their lives at Jesus' feet.
His love. That's one of the reasons we're on the air night by night. This need to know his love and to reach out then horizontally and touch others in his name is that which gives urgency to the evangelist, to those in the healing ministries. Thank you for being willing to receive his love. Let's remember as we go and personalize this. I am only one person, but I am one person. I can't do everything, but I can do something. What I can do, I ought to do. And what I ought to do, by the grace of God, I will do. In love, okay? As we lay our heads on the pillow tonight or go out tomorrow, spread love. Thanks so much. Bill Pearce, Night Sounds. Till next time, a peaceful good night.